Hi, I'm Pastor Goodman.
And this is the Largely Catechized Life.
So when we pray, lead us not into temptation, we recognize that we all feel temptation. And you know, I pretty well cover the gambit in breaking the Ten Commandments, but truth be told, I've got some favorite sins. And my favorite sins aren't necessarily going to be your favorite sins. In the Large Catechism, Luther writes about temptation, we all must feel it, although not all in the same manner, but some in a greater degree and more severely than others, as the young suffer especially from the flesh afterwards, they that attain to middle life and old age from the world, but others who are occupied with spiritual matters, that is, strong Christians, from the devil. See, we tend to seek out people who sin like we sin because we can understand it. As a pastor, it's really easy for me to pick like three sins that I don't see being done in my congregation and just rail against them because nobody's going to yell at me later. So I can say, I don't know, like homosexuality, abortion, and terrorism. And since I haven't seen anybody I know do these things, it's easy to say those can't be Christians, not people who do that. As a parent, it's so easy to write off the struggles of youth as they wrestle with the sixth commandment and what it is to live a chaste and decent life. And as a child, it's so easy to call those older than you greedy and self-absorbed. All of us tend to be so comfortable with our own sin that we understand that temptation, but we tend to forget the fact that others are tempted differently than us. But because we are so comfortable with our own sin and can see why it would be accepted, that doesn't mean that it's okay to call other people who sin differently than you gross. If anything, it just says you might be a little bit too comfortable with your own sin. And it also probably says that you need a lot more compassion for your neighbor. Take heed. Recognize that your struggle is also being fought by your neighbor, even if it is against something you don't quite understand. And have compassion by recognizing that Jesus died for you and for your sins, but also for your neighbor and for their sins, even those who sin differently than you, because Christianity isn't us versus them. It's Jesus versus sin, death, and the power of the devil. And he was crucified to overcome all of these things. So when we pray, lead us not into temptation, we pray both for those that we understand and the temptation to write off those that we don't.